So, Surya, let's try and understand this a little better in the sense that, you know, when we talk of annuities, annuities are taxed in your hand, they get carried on and added to your income.
Your taxable income.
Your taxable income, that's right. Which could be 20% or
30%. Depending on your marginal rate of tax which you come
in. Do you therefore as a planner prefer the approach where you build a corpus for your retirement and once you've retired, you draw down on that corpus, say through a systematic withdrawal plan kind of a thing? Is that more tax friendly, tax efficient? Because people tend to buy financial products because it gives you a tax break without probably understanding in the long run, is this beneficial to me or not?
See, that's a very interesting point, Vivek, because you have to also look at from the investor psyche. Mm-hmm. Some of the investors like to lock in their money and not have access to it. So if you come under that set of investors, it's a no-brainer. You please go and invest in NPS because by default, your money is locked in and is not touched. It's not touchable by you because that money is locked in. You cannot withdraw it. But in case your access of money is easy and many investors then end up touching that corpus by whatever name you may have called that as, it could be a retirement corpus also, but if it's available, you will take it out. So if you can create that discipline, then definitely what you say holds an advantage. But mind you, NPS does give you that extra tax rebate by saving that 50,000, but that amount is not that large enough. So in case of an investor who is in a highest tax bracket and a very higher income bracket, higher income in hand, then the real advantage may not be that, may not be
too much. In fact, you may even suffer a loss.
So
because if over 30 years you've built a 3-4 crore kind of a corpus and then you are paying a heavy tax on the annuity that you're getting.
So it will depend on your taxable income at that point of time.
Sure.
So if you can plan it correctly, so it's not that you're missing something by not investing into this. So you have to play your cards and pay your cards well. Provided you are, again, I'm repeating the same thing, provided you are able to do a disciplined approach to your savings and you know that unless really something dramatic happens or an emergency or a contingency, you will not touch that retirement corpus of yours, then you can actually start doing a systematic withdrawal plan, as you're rightly saying, which is actually a very highly tax efficient way of having withdrawing money and creating a retirement kitty for yourself.